In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily merge multiple MP3 files into a single MP3 file using MS-DOS. With a Windows installation, you get a choice of four operating systems. One of these operating systems is the Microsoft Disk Operating System, MS-DOS. This is the operating system that Windows replaced. It's a non-graphical operating system, and you access it using the command prompt, also known as CMD. Now, before we jump into MS-DOS, you'll need to know two MS-DOS commands to successfully merge files, CD and copy. CD is short for change directory. This is the command you'll use to navigate through directories, also known as folders, in a drive. The copy command copies one or more files into another location. With that out of the way, let me show you how to merge multiple MP3 files into a single MP3 file using MS-DOS. Click on Windows Search or Cortana and search for Command Prompt or CMD. Command Prompt will show up in the search results. Click on it to launch or press Enter. Alternatively, you can also launch CMD from the Run command. Simultaneously press the Windows and R keys and then type CMD. Click OK or press Enter to launch Command Prompt. Now, open Windows Explorer and navigate to the folder that contains the files. Click on the address bar to reveal the folder path. Note the drive letter, in this case it's G, and then copy the folder path. Head back to Command Prompt and type the drive letter and a colon. The drive that contains the folder that contains my files is drive G. So I type G colon and hit enter. This is how you navigate to drives in MS-DOS. Type in the drive letter, colon, and hit enter. Now that we're in the right drive, let's navigate to the folder that contains the files. We'll use the change directory command. So type CD space, then right click with your mouse. Right clicking with your mouse pastes the folder path that we copied from the address bar. Press enter. And you have successfully navigated to the folder that contains your files. We are going to use the copy command to merge two MP3 files into a single MP3 file. In MS-DOS, I find it useful to see the command parameters. So I'll type help, copy, and hit enter. Here are the parameters or the syntax of the copy command. So to append files, we'll need to type copy space and then the parameters, backward stroke A, B, D, and so forth. Then the source files with a plus sign between them and then the destination file. Let's write this out. So copy space, MP3 are binary files. So we'll want to use the stroke B parameter, stroke B. Then our source files with plus signs between them. So audio from DVD01.mp3 plus audio from DVD02.mp3. You do need to make sure that you type in the exact names of the files with their extensions. Then a space and the name of the destination file. I will name mine merge MP3. Then press enter. Once MS-DOS is done, you'll get an output of the merged files. Heading back to my source folder, we can see the merge.mp3 file has been created. A few nota bene. If your file names have spaces, you'll need to surround them with quotes. So, opening quotes, my file 1.mp3, closing quotes, plus opening quote, my file 2.mp3, closing quote, and then the destination file name. If you don't, you get a syntax error. You can also use wildcards to define your source files. Let's say you have a folder with numerous MP3 files that you want to merge into one. Instead of writing all the file names, you can simply type copy star.mp3 wildcard, then the destination file, merge2.mp3. Then hit enter, and all the MP3 files in the folder will be combined into one file. You can define the folder path of your destination file. Simply append the folder path to the destination file name. So G colon forward stroke merge.mp3 will save the merge MP3 file in the G drive root folder. Finally, this method also works for other binary files, WAV audio, MP4 video, and so forth, and also text files, for instance, Notepad, Word, and even Excel files. Simply change the parameter to *A or remove it, as the DOS default parameter is text files. That's it for this video. If you found it useful, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, please post them in the comment section of the accompanying blog post. Link in the description below. See you next time and have a great day.